Disney's Beauty and the Beast.
Every day, the one before. this poor provincial town.
Good morning, Betsy.
Good morning.
And where are you off to?
The bookshop. I just finished the most wonderful story about a beanstalk in an ogre.
That's nice. Can you read the baguettes?
Now, what do you say we take a walk over to the tavern and take a look at my trophy?
What do you say we don't? Come on, Belle, I think I know how you feel about me.
You can't even imagine.
Now, I have to get inside to help my father.
That crazy old fool? He needs all the help he can get.
Don't talk about my father that way.
Yeah, don't talk about her father that way.
My father's not crazy, he's a genius. Papa!
Some genius? What's a genius?
Now, LeFou, I want you to go into the woods and bring me back the biggest, healthiest deer you can find.
Not the woods again. I hate the woods. It's dark and spooky, and there's bugs and spiders.
Just bring me back a deer for my wedding. Papa, are you alright?
Oh, I'm fine. But I can't for the life of me figure out why that happened. It is the stubbornest piece of...
Papa!
I'm about ready to give up on this honking job.
You always say that.
I mean, this time, I'll never get this bullpen contraption to work.
Yes, you will, and you'll win first prize at the fair tomorrow. And become a world-famous inventor.
You really think so?
You know I do.
Well, we better get cracking. This thing is not going to fix itself. Now, let me see. Where did I leave that dog with a clincher?
Papa?
So tell me, did you have a good time in town today?
I got a new book.
You do love those books.
Well, they take me away to wonderful places where there's adventure, mystery, romance, and happy endings. Papa, if I ask you something, will you answer me honestly?
Don't I always?
Do you think God... odd?
My daughter? Odd. Now, where'd you get an idea like that?
I don't know, it's just that, well, people talk.
Well, they talk about me too. No, I'm not odd or you. No family ever seen her. Except one uncle who will maybe let that pass. Say or do, you couldn't make it plainer. You are your mother's daughter, therefore you are blessed.
So I should just accept I'm simply not like you.
They are coming good, and you can take my word. You are unique, creme de la creme.
It works!
does. It does.
You did it, Papa. You really did it. I know you'll win first prize in the fair tomorrow. I know it.
Who knows? Maybe I will at that.
I almost forgot. I made you a scarf for good luck.
Now I'm sure I'll win. And then we'll leave this town and go to all those places you read about in your books. Well, I'm off.
Goodbye, Papa.
Bye-bye.
And be careful.
I'm not seeing this.
Oh la la! What do we have here? Do my eyes see me? Or is this a man? Oh, it's been so long since I've seen a real man. No offense, Lumiere. Bonjour, monsieur. Mind if I sit here?
Oh, well, hello.
That's it. This has gone on far enough. I'm in charge here, and I've...
How would you like a nice cup of tea, sir? It'll warm you up in no time.
No, he'll be here all night. No tea.
Oh, yes, please. This is just fine.
I think I scared him, Mama.
Hey there, little fellow. What's your name?
Chip.
Figures.
Can't wear a blanket, monsieur? I just leveled him in.
I bet you're always trying to make me jealous. Well, it's not going to work this time.
Me? What about you?
Jacques?
Michel?
Pierre?
Véronique?
Véronique. Lumiere, we've got to get him out of here. Do you have any idea what the master would do if he found out we let a stranger in?
Calm yourself, Cogsworth. The master will never have to know. As I was saying, he's bound to find out sooner or later.
Should we hide?
No, though. Remain calm. There's absolutely no reason to panic.
Lumiere's right. There's absolutely no reason to panic. Careful with this.
There's a stranger here.
Master, allow me to explain.
Who let him in? Master, may I take this opportunity to say, I was against it from the start.
Who dared to disobey me?
Oh, dear.
You have all been trained. Who are you?
Maurice.
What are you doing here?
I lost my way to the woods.
You are not welcome in my castle.
I'm sorry, I'll just be early.
It's hideous, isn't it?
Oh, no, I wasn't.
You've come to stare at the beast, haven't you?
No, I meant no harm. I was just merely looking for a place to stay.
I'll give you a place to stay.
We shall be the perfect pair.
Who does?
Wiped into this whole spell business. It's not like we threw an old beggar woman out on her ear.
No, but are we not responsible for helping to make him the way he is?
I suppose so.
All I know is, I will eventually melt away into nothing. And I only hope there's something of me left if the master ever breaks the spell.
We've got to hold on, old man. We've got to hold on.
Hello? Is anyone here? Hello?
It's a girl. Yes, of course I can see it's a girl. It's a girl!
Mademoiselle.
Now, come here, let me do all the talking.
You!
It's out of the house unless you do most of the talking.
Sherry,
a word, just a word, that's all I'm asking.
Mama, Mama, you're never gonna believe what I saw. Not in a million years. Not in a million trillion thousand years.
Yes, dear.
No, really, this is the greatest thing. It's the thing we've all been waiting for since... I don't know when.
All right, Chip, what is it?
There's a girl in the castle. Bless my soul.
Wouldn't that be lovely?
But there is. I saw her.
Now, Chip, I'll not have you running around getting everyone's hopes up for no reason.
Mrs. Potts! Did you hear? There's a girl in the castle!
See? I told ya.
And she's real pretty, too.
Well, I don't know about that.
This is the one! The girl we have been waiting for! She has come to Betsy Sparrow!
Wait a minute. Let's not be hasty.
Isn't this wonderful? Oh, happy, happy day!
Stop it. Stop that.
We should tell the others, no?
Yes. I mean, no. I mean, wait a minute.
Hello? Is anyone here? Please! I'm looking for my father. Hello?
Is that you?
Papa!
How did you find me here?
Your hands are like ice. We've got to get you out of here.
Clip, Belle. We must leave this place.
I won't leave you here. Who's there? I know someone's there. Who are you?
The master of this castle.
Then you're the one responsible for this. Release my father at once.
I am the master of this castle. I do not take orders from anyone. Throw her out.
No, wait, please. Can't you see he's not well?
Then he should not have trespassed.
But he's an old man, he could die.
He came into my home uninvited and now he'll suffer the consequences.
No, please, I'll do anything.
There's nothing you can do.
Take me instead.
No! What did you say?
Take me instead.
Belle, you don't know what you're doing.
You would do that? You would take his place?
If I did, would you let him go?
Yes, but you must stay here forever.
No!
But that's not fair!
Forever! Or he dies in the dungeon.
Wait. Come into the light.
Make your choice.
Belle, I'm old. I lived my life.
You have my word.
Done.
Papa!
Oh,
no!
Please!
No!
Spare my daughter!
Sorry, no! Papa!
Take him to the crossroads.
Let her go!
Papa!
No! Master!
Roar!
Master, since the girls went with us for some time, I went off to her room.
You didn't let me say goodbye.
What?
I'll never see him again if you didn't let me say goodbye.
I'll show you to your room.
My room, but I thought...
You want to stay in that dungeon?
No.
Then follow me. Follow me! This is your home now. You're free to go anywhere you like, except the West Wing.
What's in the West Wing?
It's forbidden! You are never to set foot there, do you understand? Do you understand?
Yes!
This is your room. I hope to be comfortable here. If you need anything, my servants will attend. And one more thing, you will join me for dinner. That is not a request.
Potsteer. Pleased to make your acquaintance.
But you're,
Mrs. Potsteer. Very pleased.
Oh! Stop. But who are you?
Madame de la Grange. Pleased to make your acquaintance. Perhaps you've heard of me?
I'm sorry.
You see? Fall under one little spell and...
Shh! But this is impossible.
Well, of course it is, but here we are. Now, let's see, what shall we dress you at for dinner? Spindrum, dear. This is nice, but how would you like to wear one of my gowns? Of course, I've got it in storage now, but when I find it, you will love it. I wore it the night I performed at the Royal Opera. The king himself was there. Of course, I won't have a prayer fitting into it now, but when I find it, it's yours.
That's very kind of you, but I'm not going to dinner.
Of course you are. The master said so.
He may be your master, but he's not mine. I'm sorry, this is just happening all so fast.
That was a very brave thing you did, my dear.
We all think so.
I'm going to miss my papa so much.
We know, but we're here to see you.
Not a bit of this crappy
at once. I have minutes to lose.
Calm down, Maurice. Who has Belle locked in a dungeon?
A beast, a terrible, monstrous beast.
Is it a big beast?
Huge.
Is it alive?
Yes, yes.
And a log in his mouth?
Oh.
Is it ugly?
And sharp, cool fangs?
Yes. Will you please help?
All right, old man. We'll help you out.
Thank you. All right. I'll go get that. Something on your back.
What are you talking about? Ah! What is that?
It appears to be a winding handle of sorts.
Get it off me!
It won't come off.
What do you mean it won't come off? It wasn't there last night when I went to bed. Why is this happening to me?
It's the spell, I'm afraid.
Just try to relax.
Relax? How can I relax when this appendage is on my back? Is there no dignity left for me in the world? What's gonna go next, my mind?
Calm down, it'll be alright.
I'm frightened, Lumiere.
I know, my friend, but you're not alone.
We're all in this together.
It's time for dinner. Where is she?
Perhaps I should see about her. Won't be a minute.
I told her to come down to dinner. It's taking so long.
Try to be patient, sir. The girl has lost her father and her freedom all in one day.
Master, have you thought that perhaps this girl could be the one to break the spell?
Of course I have. I'm not a fool.
Good. So you fall in love with her, she falls in love with you, and poof, we're human again by midnight.
Lumiere, it's not that easy. These things take time.
But we don't have time. The rose has already begun to wilt.
It's no use. She's so beautiful, and I'm... Well, look at me.
He has a point.
Master, you must help her see past all that.
I don't know how.
You could start by looking more presentable. Straighten up. Act like a gentleman.
Impress her with your rapier wit.
But be gentle.
Shower her with compliments.
But be sincere.
And above all,
what?
You must control your temper.
Well?
What?
Where is she?
Who? Oh, well, she's in the process of circumstances as they are. Not coming. You're not coming.
What did you say?
It's not coming.
We'll see about that!
Your lordship, your eminence, your grace.
Stay where you are!
Let's not be hasty.
Lumiere, stand aside! I thought I told you to come down to dinner.
I'm not hungry.
I am the master of this castle, and I'm telling you to come to dinner.
And I'm telling you I'm not hungry.
You are hungry if I say you're hungry.
Don't be ridiculous.
What did you say?
You can't go around ordering people to be hungry.
I can.
Besides, it's rude.
Oh, rude is it? Well, how about this then? If you don't come down to dinner, then I will drag you by the hair.
Master, that may not be the best way to win the girl's affections.
Then why is she being so difficult? Why are you being so difficult?
Why are you being such a bully?
Because I want you to come down to dinner.
So you admit it. You are being a bully.
Deep breaths, Master. Deep breaths.
I'll give her one last chance. Would you be so kind as to come to dinner with me? Please.
No, thank you.
Fine, then stop. If she doesn't eat with me, she doesn't eat at all.
What were we thinking? We'll never be human again.
So it appears.
Well, what would you two have us do? Give up? I can't give up until I hear the sound of my boy's laughter as he runs through these halls again.
Quite right, Miss Potts. We mustn't give up while there's still a chance. Lumiere, stand guard. If there's the slightest change, inform me at once.
We won't, Captain.
I asked nicely, but she refuses. What does she want me to do, beg? Show me the girl.
I know the master can be a bit temperamental, but I don't mean all that bad at her. He's not such a bad guy. Why not give him a chance?
Why should I? Did he give my father a chance?
Well, no. But he's not really that bad.
I don't want to get to know him. I want nothing to do with him.
She'll never see me as anything but a monster.
Crust of bread, some water, then off to bed.
Cogsworth! I'm surprised at you. Where are your manners? She's not our prisoner. She's our guest.
Okay, fine. Dinner. But keep it down. If the master finds out, it'll be our necks.
Of course, of course. But what is dinner without a little music?
Music?
Fashion, my music. It is with deepest pride and greatest pleasure that we welcome you here tonight. Now let us pull up a chair. As a dining room proudly presents your dinner. Be our guest. Be our guest. Put our service to the test. Tie your napkin around your neck, Shelly, and we'll provide you with soup de jour, hot hors d'oeuvres. Why, we only live to serve. Try the gray stuff.
It's delicious.
Don't believe me? Ask the dishes. They can see, they can dance. After all, this is France, and the dinner here is never second best. Go for your menu, take a glance, then you'll be our guest.
Be ragu, cheese soufflé, pie, pudding, all bonnet, all prepared, serve a fair culinary cabaret.
You're alone when you're scared, the banquet's all prepared.
No one's gloomy or complaining while the flat was entertaining.
So just
I do tricks with my fellow candlesticks.
And it's all in perfect taste that you can get. Come on and lift your glass, you want your milk.
Daisy.
Look at the time. Off to bed.
I couldn't possibly go to bed now. It's my first time in an enchanted castle.
Enchanted? Who said the castle was enchanted? It was you, wasn't it?
I figured it out for myself. I'd like to look around, if that's all right.
Perhaps a door. I'm not sure that's the greatest idea. We can't have you-know-who poking around you-know-where, if you know what I mean.
Perhaps you'd like to take me. I'm sure you know everything there is to know about this castle.
Well, actually I do. May I draw your attention to the hand-painted ceilings, complete with sheriffs frolicking amongst the nymphs and centaurs?
Act like a gentleman. Act like a gentleman. This will be good. Belle? Oh, Belle!
And if you will note the inverted archways, it is yet another example of our new flake. Neoclassical Baroque period. And as I always say, if it's not Baroque, don't fix it. And if you'll note the flying buttresses amongst the aviary.
Wow, it's also amazing. I had no idea. Only he weren't here.
Act like a gentleman. I'm nothing but a fool.
And thanks to me, the disaster was averted. That's the last time a stone of that size was quarried in this area.
What's up there?
Nothing. Nothing of any interest in the West Wing.
So that's the West Wing.
Nice going.
It wouldn't be forbidden, would it?
Perhaps Mademoiselle would like to see something else. We have tapestries dating all the way back to Aloysius the Pretentious.
Maybe later.
Perhaps the garden. Or the library.
You have a library?
With books.
Yes, scads, mountains, cloudbursts, swamps of books.
Books with words.
More words than you could read in a lifetime.
Books on every subject by every author who ever set pen to paper. Write this one.
Illusion.
long ago I should have seen all the things I could have been. Careless and unthinking, I moved onward.
Have you taken a good look at the rose recently? It's losing petals at an alarming rate.
Not to mention, I can hardly bend over anymore.
We must find a nice romantic way to draw them closer together.
I have just the thing. How about we warm you two up with a little bit of soup?
Soup?
Trust me.
There's something sweet in all of his kind. And he was dear and he was close.
Will I ever get to be a boy again?
I sure hope so.
When will I know?
If it is
called Excalibur. Arthur tried to pull it from his stone. He tried once to no avail. He tried a second time, but still, he could not pull it out. Then, for the third time, Arthur drew forth his sword.
So that must mean that he's king.
Wait and see.
I never knew books could do that.
Do what?
Take me away and make me forget for a little while.
Forget?
Who I am. What I am.
You know, we have something in common.
What?
The town where I come from, the people think I'm odd.
You?
So I know how it feels to be different, and I know how lonely that can be. For the third time, Arthur drew forth the sword, and there arose a great shout from the people. Arthur is king!
Told you so.
You're still in there.
Yes, and so far he's been a perfect gentleman. The day we have waited for might finally be at hand.
If only that was human again.
Yes, think what that means. Human again.
I'll be cooking again, be good looking again, with the bad ones held on each arm. When I'm human again, only human again, voice polished and with charm.
Oh,
leave the asylum in the middle of the night, but this fellow said you'd make it worth my while.
Look, I got my heart set on marrying Belle. She needs a little persuasion.
Turned her down flat.
It's like this. I want to marry Belle, but I can't do that with Maurice in the way.
And who better to help than Monsieur Dark of the Maison de Lune?
Look, I don't wish to seem obtuse, but I don't see how I can be of use, for I lock people up and I'm not a Lonely Hearts Club.
It's Belle's father who's your client. She adores crazy old Maurice. But she'll be forced to be mine. I just need to pronounce him mad. Do I make myself clear?
It's the simplest deal of my whole foul career.
Just put Maurice away and she'll be my bride.
She'd rather die.
So, book the church and raise the glasses high to the Maison de Lune.
I don't know if I can do that.
You must. There will be dinner. You care for the girl, don't you?
More than anything.
Then why not tell her?
I don't know if I can.
You must. There will be dinner, music, romantic candlelight, provided by myself. And then, when the moment is right...
How will I know when the moment is right?
You will feel slightly nauseous.
No.
You will feel it in here. And you must speak from the heart.
Speak from the heart! I really don't think I can do this.
Master, look at the rose. There's so little time left.
What are you afraid of? Nothing.
Master.
I'm afraid she might...
She might what?
Laugh at me.
Well, somehow my prince must find the courage to take that chance. Here. Maybe this will be your courage. You can do it, my prince. I know you can.
Thank you. Belle, there's something I've been meaning to ask.
Yes?
Belle, are you happy here?
Of course, everyone's so friendly. Miss Potts, Lumiere?
With me?
Yes!
I must speak from the heart. Belle, is something wrong?
I miss my father. I wish I could see him again.
There is a way. This mirror will show you anything you wish to see.
I'd like to see my father, please. Oh no! He's in the woods. I think he's lost. I should...
Go to him.
What?
You should go to him.
What about...
You're not my prisoner anymore. Haven't been for a long time. Keep it. There's a way to remember. Go!
Oh, Master, I must say, everything is going quite swimmingly. I knew you had it in you.
I let her go.
You what?
How could you do that?
I had to.
But why?
He's finally learned to love.
Then that's it. That should break the spell.
It's not enough. She has to love him in return.
And now it's too late.
That good can come from there. promised you a duck.
I've come to collect your father.
What?
Don't you worry, we'll take good care of him.
My father's not crazy.
He was raving like a lunatic.
We all learned him, didn't we?
Yeah.
All right, come along quietly now.
I won't let you do this.
Tell us again, old man, how big was this beast?
Well, he was enormous. He was at least 10. No, more like 8 feet tall.
You don't get much crazier than that.
It's true, I tell you.
All right.
What are you doing? Let go of me!
Papa!
All right, Maurice, tell me. When did you first start having these delusions?
It's not a delusion. The beast was real, so was the talking clock.
Poor Bill. It's a shame about your father.
You know my father's not crazy.
I might be able to clear up this little misunderstanding if...
If what?
If you'll marry me.
What? Never!
Have it your way. Take the old man.
No, let go of me. Belle!
Wait, I can prove my father's not crazy. Show me the beast.
That's him. That's him.
Is he dangerous?
Oh no, he never hurt anyone. I know he looks frightful, but he's actually very gentle and kind. He's my friend.
If I didn't know any better, I'd say you had feelings for this monster.
He's not the monster, Gaston, you are.
She's as crazy as the old man. She says his creatures are frightened, like hunted wild animals, and I've seen what they can do. The beast will make off with their children. He'll come after them in the night.
They never do that.
Thank you.
the castle's under attack.
Let them come.
We are. No. No, please. Please don't leave me. I love you.
Now, two hearts become one. people that we want to thank. First off, we want to thank Miss T, who just got here a couple weeks ago. She's a new theater teacher. Thank you for the technical aspect of this musical. We want to thank Miss Schuford, who is in charge of the music. That was awesome. Mr. Walcott assisted backstage and created the set with his students. Mr. Dale created the programs and helped behind the scenes in way too many ways to mention. Miss Moore helped create the set and all the costumes. And finally, we want to thank Miss Paul, who is finishing her career at Washington with her 20th theater production. And we would like to have all the seniors come up here for a minute. Okay, well, we just wanted to thank everybody. Thank you for making this possible.
Right here.
Oh, there she is. Yeah. She's being pushed out the aisle. Come on.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Is there anything you want to say?